Okay. Hi. I made a mistake. So this is probably gonna be edited into the original Malvalence stream. But I made a mistake and I didn't read Sachi's DM before I finished stream, and Sachi's DM was, "Hey, by the way, if you get shot in the face, here's how you get the actual ending." So, yeah. Okay, so I've got this save right here that's right before the ending. But if I hit start again, does this default to...
Hello?
I want to check out some of the puzzles on hard. How do I... Options... Hard. This might be a bad idea, but... I want to check out a couple of these, and then we'll go and do the ending. You'd like to repeat what you said in DMs, that caution can have a little murder as a treat, yeah? Are you winning any awards for home decor? Yep, this is all stuff we've already read. Okay, what is... Is this the same? Is this puzzle the same on hard? Because it's OSS line. Don't think the first puzzle changes. And then this. This is this. I think this one is just another S. This one is the green one. Wait, did I mess this up? Do I not remember how this puzzle works? I'm showing that I don't remember how this puzzle worked. Oh, wait, So this is just an O. No, it's not. What? Gosh, I'm showing my smooth-brainedness again. There we go. Okay. Let's see how some of these ones are. 18, 10, and 7. And we're splitting it into two doses of 9. I didn't save before I started messing around. Whoops. Why did I do that? Oh, wait, it will restart me at the start of the room. So we have a 1 here. And Sashi said that this puzzle was easier on hard. Thank you, Caution. Thank you for the murder. Okay, what is this puzzle? Oh, Lord, this is more complicated. You think that combination just clicked easier? That's fair. Also, I couldn't put my finger on it, but this game's music reminds me really heavily of a different game, but I don't know what game it is. Don't have any straight pieces. But yeah, I make no promises that I will actually finish the game on hard, but... Because, we all saw how smooth-brained I can be. Getting further than you ever did if I clear either of the other puzzles in this room. That's a wonderful sign. That fits like that. I do find it kind of funny that, like, Caution is just like, how the hell did you break the lock? Despite the fact that he very clearly put a puzzle lock on the door. Oh, this is really close. That doesn't work either. I don't have the three tall one here anymore. You know, that actually, that seems like a reasonable explanation. I'll accept that as an explanation for that. And Caution just never thought to check the locks. Shit, that's so close. Oh. That's really close as well. That works. Cool. But yeah, I'll have to stream the prequel game to this. At some point, like, oh God. Prequel's a pure visual novel. No puzzles. It's never stopped me from playing a game before. Oh. Oh shit, I forgot to save after the bomb puzzle. Okay, how did this fit together again? There's some shit like this goes here. This went here. I think we put this here, like this. Maybe this... I've made a mistake. I've made a very critical mistake here. Okay, so what have I done wrong here? That still doesn't work. gosh. I swear, there's gonna be enough footage of me, there it is. And now I will save. Okay, so... This is 100% the type of puzzle that I would brute force the fuck out of when I was younger. Shit. That was pretty damn close, though. Look at that. Also, one of the things that scares me the most about this puzzle on hard is, one of the top Steam guides for this game is how to do this puzzle on hard. This is fucked. I've already messed this up. I'm actually gonna make another save right here. Okay, so... The biggest thing is that we need to get this pillar down a bit. You see, now my brute forcing brain is coming into... coming in to do the work. Yeah, since those are... okay, so... on this one, you understand the general method. And that's fucked as well. My biggest thing is that, like... yeah. I do kind of understand this. Do that, then this makes this possible to get to. Yeah, the instant that you get one of those blocks like that, and you just can't interact with it, it's you're just done. So, I guess... let's focus on going off to the right, because we need to clear two lines to get this down to be flush with this. But there's no codes. There's no codes that have these two symbols next to each other. So this tower needs to come down three at minimum. Because I feel like the whole idea here is that you kind of need to collapse the tower in such a way. See, this is... yeah. This one, no. Gosh, this puzzle is a significant jump in difficulty. One thing, like, one little UI thing that I kind of wish that this puzzle had is if you hover over a combination that works, the combination that works on the code list should light up. So you're not, like, hovering over a thing and then scanning back and forth to see what it will delete if you click it. Wait, what? That's not a... Yeah, and this... I think my brain is just too smooth for this. This is gonna take me longer than the Panopticon puzzle did, or the line puzzle. I do genuinely want to see what those puzzles are like on hard. That's... So... I wonder if it's something along the lines of... Come on. This type of puzzle requires a lot more foresight than I'm capable of giving. That's fucked. Portal's gonna be such a fun game to stream. I'm gonna be so bad at it. Shit, that was so good. So I think I'm onto something with starting off with that there. No, shit, that was the wrong one. So we start with this, and we do the triple zeros here, and the 110 here. Nope. I just did the exact same thing that I said was wrong. Sorry I'm not talking a whole lot, this is like... There. That. So, how many times have I restarted this? Too many? No, you are not meant to be keeping track. That already doesn't work. Yeah, I don't think that this stack is gonna work. I think I have to load back to the previous one. Okay, so that block is completely fucked. Gosh, they weren't kidding when they said that these puzzles are hard. So just gonna make a save in case I mess this up. Not that I know that I have this in the bag or anything. I might switch this puzzle specifically to easy mode. Or to normal, I guess, but we're just messing around. So, okay. How in the world did we end up with this? What? Why did that not just immediately end? What? Huh? Okay, so let's look at this. So 011 is not a code. End of my thought process. So, I have this weird thing in my brain where essentially we have to clear three lines out from these two rows here to be able to interact with these numbers properly. I think I will switch the difficulty down for this, just because this puzzle specifically is, like, really hard. So I'll do this puzzle real quick. I'll see if I can figure this out. Okay, so... Supposed to do this in equal doses of 9. Gaming. Okay, so wait, some of these have duplicates. Sorry about that. Okay, and I think I'm going to swap difficulty to medium. Actually, I'm gonna mess around with this just a little bit more. Thank you. Huh. Come on, that's so close. Stupid faces in this. That doesn't work. That doesn't work either. Sorry if this is boring to watch, like... There has to be some combination of things to do here that will cause this stack to decay in such a way that this face and this face don't end up lined up. Which that would mean that this stack needs all four of these line clears to include this one block and none of this block. No. What just clicked, Sochi? This must be like a maximum security clearance laptop. Caution, can you please give me some leeway here? That's... Caution's over here peeking over the stop agent's shoulder, and he's just like, "Well, well, lab rat, you really are terrible at this, aren't you?" I figured they were exaggerating in your file when they said that you couldn't code for shit. But it appears they were quite on point. That weird. That bugged out the UI for the puzzle. Stop agent is crying into the keyboard while Caution laughs. True. Okay. Mind me, I've just messed up that puzzle. Actually, what even is the intended solution for this puzzle? I don't even fully understand what this puzzle wants from me. Is it you're supposed to kill the correct ones with the correct marbles? Just threw a marble in each hole and save scum? I just guessed it correctly. Oh, I got this correct by accident. So I didn't actually ever get this wrong ending. Oof, not quite. But it's okay. I can fix this, easy peasy. Just, stand still for 1 second and... Subject was crushed by a comically large marble. That's about what I was expecting. Drop just high enough for instantaneous death and perfect comedic timing. Didn't recognize good slapstick even when it hit him. Wait, what? I got that right? Or I got that wrong? This is what comes of me getting the answer correct on the first pass through without realizing what the game actually wanted from me. Okay, so this one goes in the middle, right? No. Okay, so this one goes here. I fucked up again. So it's this one here, and this one here. What? What? That's not correct. Bomb, then poison, then hacking. Not if I do it like that. Green is poison? I thought that green was hacking.
Well, 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 if it isn't the lab rat. Well then, hey lab rat.
Caution, my beloved. Okay, let's see how they make the other stuff harder. Okay, so oh wow. Holy shit, this is a lot of things. Oh god, what the fuck? Yeah. I'll read these when I get to the actual puzzle itself. Okay, let's take a look. What? So the functions still work the same, but some of these have empty spaces. What? Wow. And you still only get 15 moves? Wow. I just realized I forgot to restart in this room, or I forgot to save. Okay, let's see how bad the puzzle that took me actually an hour last time is. This doesn't work, but... Thank you. Those four ways set up right next to the wall is actual psychopath behavior. Yeah, so... Yeah, wow. Does that work? Nope. I guess I made multiple closed loops there. That looked like it should have worked, but I didn't see where, This is really fun, just messing around with the hard mode puzzles that no one understands. Okay, so start from here. It always goes straight through. So, okay. Thank you. Huh. Yeah. So, just drawing lines through all the existing pipes, probably. So this square has to connect to the middle here, because that makes a T-junction. And this one has to go further down, because that makes a T-junction. Doesn't work. This doesn't work, does it? Oh, there's a T-junction right there. And one right here. Is T-junction somewhere here that I'm not seeing? Oh, it's right here. That makes that. So, that works. Because you start over here, you would go over, and it would go around, and straight through down here. Doing that would loop it back around, but then output it to here. Except that doesn't work. So, okay. You go out and around and through. If I break that link, nope, that doesn't work. The return of Maddie getting stuck on one thing the entire stream. Gosh. Okay, so resolve one T junction, then just find another, yeah. So that doesn't have any T-junctions in it, but I'm pretty sure that that has multiple closed circles in it. Nope. It does have multiple closed circles in it. The whole no closed loops thing is what's really making this difficult for me. Caution very specifically wants this wiring to only contain one brain cell, not two. Still doesn't do anything different. So, my issue is that I need something to break off of this shape here into the other shape with a forced turn. Junction. And this is just the answer that got me. That's incorrect. This stupid square. Labrat, have you ever played BioShock? This puzzle is kind of like that. Actually, not really, but BioShock does have the pipe puzzles for the hacking minigame. You see, Labrat, this wiring is inside your own head because you only have one brain cell. So that... that has to be like that because of this having three output points to it, which also means that this has to be like this. Wait, no. I may be stupid. So, we have this. Yeah, get you some sleep, Sachi. I'll probably mess around with this for a little bit, and then I'll go do the ending. I'm not planning on streaming to my normal late hours. I'm probably just gonna mess around with this a little bit more and then go do the ending. Because this is the main, thing that I wanted to mess around with here. Actually, I think I'm actually done messing around with this. We'll load the save from last night. Oh wait, we need to go up and down the stairs repeatedly. Where is our piece of paper? Is this just random chance? Because I think I've gotten five of them on this save. It shouldn't be. Wait, don't tell me this is a pre... oh, this is the pre-me finishing the quilt puzzle one, I think. Yep. Data management. Yep. That was a pre-quilt puzzle. Save. So there's six notes here. What? Quilt puzzle. I did the quilt puzzle second try. I will say that much, but man, it took me so long. Oh no, this is pre-quilt puzzle. Number five. Smiled at me, even though... okay, I think that this is new. Even though everyone else he's seen here, everyone dressed like me, acting like me, working for the same people as me, has made him suffer. He smiled at me. I'm getting better at coming up with excuses to visit him, at least. I need to evaluate how he's coping with procedures, just like the other YTDI trainees. I might need to test his reflexes. Hell, he might need a snack to make him more cooperative. All my explanations are superficially believable at best. I'm no medical professional. I'm a supervisor. I oversee things. By all means, I should have been reprimanded for getting too involved. No such warnings have come my way. I'm never gonna be able to forget the look on his face when the convulsions started. He knew it was coming, and he knew there was nothing he could do to even brace himself for the pain. He's been through it countless times. I don't want to see it ever again. They claimed that it was a clerical error that he didn't receive his anti-seizure medications that morning. I know that it was actually punishment. He refused to obey during yesterday's mandatory exercises. You wouldn't treat an animal like this, much less another human. To them, he's less than that. Triggered the false alarm right on schedule, down to the second. My not-at-all-false explosive followed suit. I'd always understood that the chemical reaction was very simple to set up. But I still expected my first felony to present more challenges than this. Maybe I have a knack for this kind of thing. He didn't hesitate for 1 second when I asked him to come with me. As I rushed him through the fire exit, the look on his face at that moment has stuck with me. Could anyone have looked more relieved? Maybe he should have hesitated. All that awaits him in life is hiding. At least he'll have a choice from now on. So is it... Oh, there. It's down there next to the... It is six, I guess. I have no right to call myself a parent. But even so, parenthood is hard. His rehab is going as well as can be expected, but this is no way to raise a child. I can educate him, keep him fed, and care for him. But I can't give him any kind of a future, not while Stop is trying to erase our very existence. I managed to section away enough resources to last us a while, but all my internal records with Stop were destroyed by the fire. They still know I'm out here, but now I have no proof that I was ever as big a part of them as I say. It's my word against theirs, and they have far larger, more powerful allies. Bombs, sabotage, and cryptic messages on shady websites get much better traction than just sending my research notes to major news outlets. No one cares what Deirdre Destrange has to say. But when Dr. Danger blows up an energy pipeline, people look up from their food and watch. He chose the name. It's got a nice old-school appeal to it. Caution has always been eager to please and happy to spend time with me. Is it any wonder he wants to help the nefarious Dr. Danger in her fight? I should tell him no. Revenge is poison, and he's already been through too much. But I still can't bear to calculate how much of his suffering is my fault. I don't have the heart to tell him no, and I'd sooner die than judge him for how much he hates Stop. Dr. Danger and Caution are becoming a household name. That's about it. Stop is still in power. People are still too scared to take them to task. And there's still YTDI centers all over the world. If I destroy one, they'll move the children to another. That's horrible as is, but what if they don't care enough to do even that? What if they believe the YTDI is just not worth the cost? What'll happen to those children then? Something needs to change, but I'm not sure if it's something that Dr. Danger can do. And I'm not sure that Deirdre Destrange is enough for him. Then it's... this... this... oh wait, whoops. It's these, right? Like that? I think? Nope, I fucked it up. Great. So I guess it's this, then this. No, wait, isn't that the order that I just did it in? There we go. Huh? Screen behind you didn't turn on. Guess Caution really was serious about the whole silent treatment thing. The way should be clear now. You could look around a while longer, but chances are you won't like whatever else you find. Better keep moving. Looks like there's no screens in this corridor. You don't think you'll see any of Dr. Danger, either. There really isn't much else to say about this hall. If that's the case, then this is probably close to the exit. To be honest, the lack of nasally jabbering kind of puts you on edge. Not that you like that brat who called you a lab rat and trapped you in several rooms with lethal puzzles. But the silence forces you to focus on something much louder and much more disturbing. Thoughts that are only now coming to the forefront of your mind. Think about Dr. Deirdre D'Estrange. Think about the results of your investigation. Think about yourself. Tiny cog in a massive machine. Sleek, pristine, reliable machine. Carefully cleansed of the blood it's spilled. Deep, dark pit hollows in your stomach. Slowly, you make your way forward, each step heavier than the last. In a large garage filled to the brim with cardboard boxes, the exit waits for you, wide open. It's night already. Outside, you hear the quiet rushing of a river. Just a few more steps and you're out of here. And more and you'll be on the bus back home. It'll take a couple of hours to get back to HQ. You'll nap on the ride, probably, so by the time you get to your stop, you'll have enough energy to run thousands of narrow stairs. You'll reach your boss's office and... Oh, what'll happen next? You'll definitely get that bonus. If this isn't going above and beyond, you'll get a promotion. Better salary, better benefits, better home. Better life. Something you've always wanted. And maybe that'll help.
Going to take responsibility?
Not now, kid. Last thing you need is him showing up and...
I see my escape rooms have worked their magic. I didn't think it was possible, but... You're feeling guilty, aren't you?
Guilt? Is that what it is? Over something you didn't do? All those years, you must have been so proud to wear that uniform. To be a brave soldier fighting for such a pristine, justice-seeking organization like that. Feel sick. But it's not enough for you to feel bad. Because if I let you go home and get your bonuses and sleep in your nice bed, you'll be stumbling over yourself to forget everything that happened here as fast as possible. You, or your boss, or the next agent. You'll storm in here and sweep away everything me and Dr. Danger fought for. And someone better will catch me and destroy this place. And Stop will turn me into a nameless drone like I was supposed to be. Shaking. I've kind of lost Caution's voice. He's trying to put on a brave face, but he's shaking.
But I don't want that, you know? I don't want to forget my home, my books, my bugs, my bed. And I don't want to forget myself. I don't want to forget about collecting stickers or eating pudding or sewing my first pair of mittens. And I don't want to forget Dr. Danger! She saved me! She raised me! She stood up for me when no one else did! And what did Stock do? They made her a villain! They took everything away from her! They killed her!
So what are you gonna do now, Lab Rat? You still got your weapon, don't you? Come on. Hit me with your best shot. Hit me! Because if you don't, I'll... Can't deal with this anymore. You don't want to fight him. You're not going to use your gun.
Then, on behalf of Stop, die.
The bullet only grazed your cheek. Huh? Caution fell? What's going...
I missed. I had the muzzle aimed at your head. The bullet's loaded. And I missed. First try.
Caution's gaze is vacant. It's the same gaze as that boy in the scrapbook. That alone makes the pit in your stomach sink even deeper. So to fill it, you say something really, really stupid. You know, could have fired again. And at contact shot distance.
No, I couldn't have. Trying to kill you? Oh, it's a lot more tiring than I thought it would be.
Tiring?
Go. This is what you wanted, right? The exit's right there. Go back to your home. Your TV. Your money. I was fooling myself. Thinking I could do what Dr. Danger did for me. So go. I hope the guilt eats at you for the rest of your fucking life.
Slowly, you make your way towards the exit. When you finally make it outside, you turn back. Boy's still sitting there. Legs splayed haphazardly. Arms floppy. Still staring at you. You stare back at him. Give him a curt nod. He doesn't react. So without another word, you turn back. See him forcing an attempt at a villainous grin.
If you really feel that bad about it, I did sneak copies of everything you've seen here onto your device. I found your address while you were looking around. Pretty devious idea, right? Downright heinous.
Takes a deep breath, then exhales.
All right. Here's another world-class criminal scheme for you. Stop agent stakes reputation, credentials, leaks internal docs to all four corners of the net. Not a bad headline. Could make for a half-decent start to a villainous career. Your choice, obviously. But I know what I'm talking about. After all, I am a supervillain.
Wow, that's where it ends? Wow. Difference between a villain and a supervillain is presentation.
Yeah.
I do. This might sound weird. I actually really like the other ending. I like the other ending a lot. This one was good, but it kind of it hits like a weird kind of pet peeve of mine, where it always frustrates me when games have multiple endings and the good ending is the least concrete of the endings. Like, I don't know, it's a personal pet peeve of mine in games like this where it's got a whole bunch of endings. But it's a good ending. Especially because, like, I know that it's not a good ending, but there's something, like, very... There's something that feels good about, like, weirdly good about the bad ending, where it's just like, caution shoots you in the face. Like, I don't know how to reverse tower defense game where you and Caution send explosive robot toys to buildings. They're to stop buildings, yeah. But yeah. But yeah, I don't know. I think there's something about, like, the way that the bad ending, like, the bad ending has really good both writing and delivery on its lines. Because there's the line of, like, you know, where Caution's like, you know, will stop memorialize you, or will they just write you off as another, thing? And he points the gun at you and he's just like, well, what kind of scientist would I be if I didn't find out? Like, I don't know, there's something about it that's just like, it sticks with me, that's just, good line delivery. Caution's got the supervillain thing down. It goes so hard, yeah, exactly. But yeah, I guess Boxy's streaming. Let's raid Boxy. Actually, who's available? There's also an ultra bad ending where you skip every piece of optional reading and just shoot Caution. Really? Wow. Truly the worst possible ending. So yeah, I'm not entirely sure what I'm gonna be streaming tomorrow, but I'll figure something out. Otherwise, thank you for watching. Thank you for coming to my off day stream. I guess have a good one and take care.